大家好，
我是 Stella，
我是 Warren， 今天要为您念的是练习手册第14课，上主从未创造过无意义的世界。 Lesson 14 God did not create a meaningless world。 让我们先来唱吧。
上主从未创造过无意义的世界。 God did not create a meaningless world。 上主从未创造过无意义的世界。 God did not create a meaningless world。
今天观念一语道破了无意义的世界不可能存在的原因。 The idea for today is, of course, the reason why a meaningless world is impossible. 凡不是上主创造的便不存在。 What God did not create does not exist.而且任何真相存在之物只能以上主创造的形式存在。 And everything that does exist exists as he created it. 你所看到的世界与实相毫不相干。 The world you see has nothing to do with reality. 它是你自己营造出来的故不存在。 It is of your own making and it does not exist. 今天的练习从头到尾都请闭上眼睛。 The exercises for today are to be practiced with eyes closed throughout. 审查信念的时间要短，最多不超过一分钟。 The mind searching period should be short.A minute at most. 练习也不要超过三次，除非你对今天的观念感到自在。Do not have more than 3 practice periods with today's idea unless you find them uncomfortable. 这表示你真正了解这一练习的深意了。If you do, it will be because...You really understand what they are for. 今天的练习是进一步学习放掉你铭刻在世界上的自家之言，而在那儿目睹上主的圣言。 The idea for today is another step in learning to let go the thought that you have written on the world and see the word of God in their place.这一转换过程，也就是救恩之所在的最初几步，相当困难，甚至相当痛苦。The early steps in this exchange, which can truly be called salvation, can be quite difficult and even quite painful. 其中有几步还会直接陷你于恐惧的深渊。Some of them will lead you directly into fear. 但你不会被遗弃在那儿。You will not be left there. 你会超越过去的。You will go far beyond it.我们已经朝着完美的保障与完美的平安迈进了。Our direction is toward perfect safety and perfect peace. 闭起眼睛想一想，掠过脑海的种种世间苦难。With eyes closed, think of all the horrors in the world that cross your mind.不论想到什么都一一指称出来，然后否定它的真实性。Name each one as it occurs to you and then deny its reality. 上主从未创造过它，故不是真的。God did not create it and so it is not real. 例如 say...For example,
上主从未 创造过那战争故，它不是真实的。God did not create that world, and so it is not real. 上主从未创造过那空难，故它不是真实的。God did not create that airplane crash, and so it is not real. 上主从未创造过那灾难，具体指明故它不是真实的。God did not create that disaster specified, and so it is not real.
凡是你害怕发生在你自己或是你所关心的人身上的事情，都是套用今天这观念的最佳素材。 Suitable subjects for the application of today's idea also include anything you are afraid might happen to you or to anyone about whom you are concerned.在每件事上具体地指出苦难之名称。In each case, name the disaster quite specifically. 不要用泛泛之词。Do not use general terms. 例如不要说上主从未创造过疾病，而应说上主从未创造过癌症，或是心脏病，或任何令你害怕的疾病。For example, do not say God did not create illness, but God did not create cancer or heart attacks or whatever may arouse fear in you. 你此刻的所见所闻不过是你个人收集来的恐怖戏码。This is your personal repertory of horrors.At which you are looking. 这一切构成了你眼前的世界。These things are part of the world you see. 有一部分幻象是众人共有的，其余的则属于你诗人地狱的一部分。Some of them are shared illusions, and others are part of your personal hell. 这都无关紧要。It does not matter. 上主从未创造之物，只可能存在于你自觉于天心之外的心灵内。What God did not create can only be in your own mind apart from His. 因此它毫无意义。Therefore, it has no meaning. 认清这一事实。再附送一遍今天的观念作为练习的结束。In recognition of this fact, include the practice periods by repeating today's idea.
上主从未创造过无意义的世界。Lesson 14, God did not create a meaningless world.
今天的观念除了固定的练习时段以外，当然也可随时套用在令你心烦的任何事上。The idea for today can, of course, be applied to anything that disturbs you during the day, aside from the practice periods. 运用时越具体越好。Be very specific in applying it.然后这样说 ，Say，
上主从未创造过无意义的世界。Lesson 14, God did not create a meaningless world.
他从未创造过具体指明令你烦心的世界，因此它不是真实的。He did not create.Specify the situation which is disturbing you, and so it is not real. 以下是这熊的诗意 You are blessed beings indeed. 你确实是有福之人 I am that one that you know as Jesus. And we are very, very proud of you for making it this far. 我是你所知的 JC, 我们非常非常以你为荣因为你已进行到这一刻。You are now 2 weeks into the deconstruction and deconstruction of your consciousness. 现在你已经花了2周的时间来结构并重新结构你的意识。Now you must remember as you go through these lessons that we are undoing decade upon decade.Even incarnation upon incarnation of distorted ideas and fears and misinformation that has been accepted into your mind and acted upon. 现在你必须记得在你练习这些课程之际我们正在结构10年负10年甚至一世又一世以来你的心灵所接受并且付诸行动的扭曲观念恐惧及错误的讯息 And this is something to remember as you get frustrated which your ego will definitely do at times这是你在感到挫折时必须记得的一件事小我一定会不时令你感到挫折 It will say, this is the most ridiculous lesson. These things are too slow. Let's go and do an intensive weekend workshop so we can deconstruct this ego in a weekend. 小我会说这是最可笑的课程这样练习太慢了何不去参加一场周末的密集工作坊这样我们就能在一个周末结构这个小我。Those are the kind of things that your ego will begin to suggest to you. It will do this because you are now deeply challenging its control over your choices.Over your value system and over what you believe to be reality. 这是你的小我会开始建议你的事情，他会这样做是因为你现在正深入挑战小我的控制，他挑战着你的选择，你的价值体系以及你认为真实的事情。 Now, we want to warn you about this worldly reality because in this teaching, what you see as your worldThe physical world with your inhabiting a body is not actually referred to as reality. 现在我们想提醒你有关这个世界的真实性的问题，因为在这课的教导中，你眼中的这个物质世界以及你居住在一具身体里的情况，实际上不能称之为实相。Reality is your oneness with all that is. Reality is your true nature. Reality is the you without all of the fears and the distortions and beliefs.That you hold that keep you from your true nature, which is reality. 实相乃是你与万有一体不分，实相乃是你的真实本质，实相乃是你心中没有任何的恐惧和扭曲，也没有抱持任何使你远离真实本质的信念。这个才是实相，因此在你练习的过程中，请记得这一点。So be aware of.That as you're going through these lessons, and you may become confused and say, Well, if this isn't reality, what is? Well, you are going to be led towards reality. 你可能会感到困惑而说，如果这不是真实的，那么这是什么？实际上，你将被带向实相之境，你将被带回你那充满爱的真我。You are going to be led towards your loving self. You are going to be led towards a higher frequency where you will have access to different experiences, and you will begin to see that the reality that you believe you live in today is very, very different than the reality that you will be living in a year, 2 years, 5 years, or 10 years. 你将被带向你那充满爱的中国，你将被带向更高的 振动频率，因此而获得不同的经验。届时你会开始明白，你认为今日生活其中的现实，将与你未来一年、两年、五年或十年所生活的现实有着天壤之别。You will be changed to such degree in a few years that you will look back upon today and you will say,Ah, I thought I knew what reality was, but I am completely changed now. 你在几年之后会有非常大的转变，因此当你回首今日时，你会说，啊，我当时以为我知道什么是真实的，但我现在已经彻底改变了。So be conscientious, but be patient. Infinite patience brings immediate results.And what that means is, if you trust in this process, this quiet and gentle daily process, and put your faith in it, and do it as asked, whether you understand it or like it, or whether it disturbs you or not, you are going to get the greatest rewards.所以请你认真练习，但是怀着耐心，无限的耐心会带来即刻的效果。意思是，如果你相信这个过程，这个安静而温柔的每日练习，对它保持信心，并依照指示来做，不论你是否了解其内容，不论你是否喜欢其内容，也不论这内容是否令你感到不安，你将获得巨大的回报。If you become impatient and leap about or miss days and procrastinate, then you extend your suffering. That's all you're doing. You are extending the time in which you suffer before you are freed of what distorted mind. 但如果你没有耐心想要超前或是跳过几天亦或延迟耽搁，那么你就会延长自己的痛苦，这就是你这样做的结果。你延长了你受苦的时间，直到你摆脱受扭曲的心灵为止。 So remember that today, if you think, Oh, I'm gonna skip that lesson, Don't do it. Know that you are investing in the most lucrative, bountiful, and abundantThought system that there is, where there is health, happiness, joy, and eventual freedom from this earthly plane. 因此，请你今天记得这一点。如果你想我要跳过这一刻，请勿这样做。请了解你正在投资获利最大的、最慷慨的、最丰盛的思想体系，它会使你体验到健康、幸福、喜悦以及。最终的自由超越这个世间。And that's one that you know as Jesus, and we will see you again tomorrow. 我是你说句的 JC, 我们明天再会。
可恩说，其实不止在练习手册，耶稣更在整部课程许多地方都斩钉截铁地说，上主不可能创造出这个和他的生命本质截然相反的世界。
He makes it abundantly clear both in the workbook as well as many, many other places in the rest of the material that God could not have created the world because it is his absence.
耶稣是想让我们看清，死抓住自己的想法不放，背后必然。有他的具体动机，这些想法和念头不会凭空冒出，也不会像变魔术一般来来去去。练习手册第158课第四段的第一句话
They do not come and go as if by magic, a phrase used later. They do not just appear.
羞耻宽恕不是容易的事，必会激起很深的恐惧。
Forgiveness is a different process and cannot but arouse tremendous fear.
课程曾说，受惊的人会变得非常凶恶。正文第三章第一节第四段的第二句话。
Frightened people can be vicious.
耶稣在第十三课说， 认出世界无意义的本质，会让所有身处无分裂之境的人坐立不安。练习手册第十三课第二段的第一句话 ：Recognition of meaninglessness arouses intense anxiety in all the separated ones。正文第二十八章第一节第一段第六句话。如果世界早就过去了 If the world were over long ago 那么身为世界一部分的你也早就过去了 And you are part of the world You were over long ago 既然如此此刻正在想在察觉在操练的你究竟又是谁 Who thenIs the you that is thinking and feeling and doing these exercises? 这个问题所指涉的答案怎么可能不把我们打入恐惧的深渊? The answer to this question leads directly into fear. 正文第十八章第九节第三段 He will lead you through the cycle of fear to the love of God that is on the other side. 唯圣灵能将我们由恐惧的深渊带到彼岸的上主圣爱那儿。正文第二十二章第三节第六段的第七句话，没有比这看外表的知见更盲目的了。Nothing so blinding as perception of form.指的就是共有幻象这个重要的观念。The text states an important statement to which we shall frequently return. 正文第二十三章第二节第五段。想一想，这对天父和圣子的关系可能产生什么表面上似乎真实的影响。Think.What this seems to do the relationship between the father and the son. 他们从此好是两个不同的生命。Now it appears that they can never be one again. 一方并会遭另一方定罪。For one must always be condemned and by the other. 他们不止分歧还会反目成仇。Now are they different and enemies? 他们之间形成敌对的关系，就像圣旨内每个部分那样，一照面就起冲突，更遑论结合了。And their relationship is one of opposition, just as the separate aspects of the sun meet only to conflict, but not to join.挫败的一方势力大减，另一方则趁机做大。One becomes weak, the other is strong by his defeat. 上主之子，因着对自己和造物主的种种作为，使他对上主的恐惧以及对彼此的戒惧，越加显得理所当然，而且真实无比。And fear of God and of each other now appears as sensible, made real by what the Son of God has done both to himself and his creator. 第六段第二句话，这种心态企图界定创造真相的造物主，诸如他因作何想，他必信何事。他又会如何答复等等，并且对此深信不疑。Here is a principle that would define what the creator of reality must be, what he must think and what he must believe, and how he must respond believing it.甚至不想向上主查证自己加在上主头上的信念究竟是真是假。It is not seen as even necessary that he be asked about the truth of what has been established of his belief. 他只会提醒上主他该如何又如何，上主别无选择。若不接纳圣旨的看法，他就必错无疑。 His son can tell him this, and he has but the choice whether to take his word for it or be mistaken. 第六句，如果上主不可能犯错，他不能不同意圣子心目中的自我形象，同时又恨圣子那副德性。For if God cannot be mistaken, he must accept his son's belief in what he is and hate him for it. 正文第二十六章第七节第七段的第三句话，果真如此，天堂就出现了一个对手，与他自身一样真实。If this were so, would heaven be opposed by its own opposite as real as it? 上主的旨意从此一分为二，所有的教化都得臣服于两种相似的法则及力量，直到上主忍无可忍，把冒犯天条的世界放逐出去。Then would God's will be split into, and all creation be subjected to the laws of two opposing powers until God becomes impatient, splits the world apart, and relegates attack unto himself. 上主就这样发疯了，他竟然宣称罪已改造了他的实相，从此圣爱不得不屈服于因果报应的淫威。 Thus has he lost his mind, proclaiming sin has taken his reality from him and brought his love at last to vengeance heals. 第八段，没有人能为无意义之物带来意义。Nothing gives meaning where no meaning is. 只有真相无需捍卫自己的真实性， and truth needs no defense to make it true. 幻象既缺见证也无后果。 Illusions have no witnesses and no effect. 着眼于幻象的人只是自欺而已。Who looks on them is but deceived.
让我们再来唱一次吧。
上主超为创造过无意义的世界。God did not create a meaningless world. 上主超为创造过无意义的世界。God did not create a meaningless world.
练习手册第十四课，上主从未创造过无意义的世界。Lesson 14, God did not create a meaningless world.
教师指南 Manual for Teachers. 八，如何避免难易有别的观念。 8. How can perception of order of difficulties be avoided?
相信事实难易有别乃是世俗之见的理论基础。 The belief in order of difficulties is the basis for the world's perception. 他的认知完全建立在差异性上，每个画面都有错落有致的背景，变化多端的前景，高低不同，大小不等，明暗不一，以及成千上万的对比，每一物都想把另一物逼下去，才能博得注目的眼神。 It rests on differences on uneven background and shifting foreground onequal heights and diverse sizes, on varying degrees of darkness and light, and thousands of contrasts in which each thing seen competes with every other in order to be recognized. 庞大之物会把小东西逼下去。A larger object overshadows a smaller one. 亮眼的东西会比暗淡无光之物吸引人。A brighter thing draws the attention from another with less intensity of appeal. 在世俗眼光中比较刺激人的或是比较吸引人的观念都会搅乱心理的平衡。And a more threatening idea, or one conceived of as more desirable by the world's standards, completely upsets the mental balance. 人的肉眼最爱着眼于冲突。What the body's eyes behold is only conflict. 别想从他们那儿寻求平安与了解。Look not to them for peace and understanding. 幻想说穿了不外是种种分别相罢了。Illusions are always illusions of differences. 除此之外还有什么其他的幻想可言？ How could it be otherwise?幻象万文深意，他必有把自己认为重要但又明知其为虚幻之物弄假成真的企图。 By definition, an illusion is an attempt to make something real that is regarded as of major importance but is recognized as being untrue.人心基于想要拥有的强烈欲望，必会设法将幻象变得真实无比。The mind therefore seeks to make its true out of its intensity of desire to have it for itself. 幻象只是仿效创造的拙劣赝品，企图把真理带入世界的骗局之中。Illusions are travesties of creation, attempts to bring truth to lies. 当人心感到难以接受真相时，必会起身抵制真相，还会为自己营造出一个胜利的假象。Finding truth unacceptable, the mind revolts against truth and gives itself an illusion of victory.人心若发觉健康成了一种负担，便会逃避到一个发烧的梦境。Finding health a burden, it retreats its feverish dreams. 心灵一旦陷入这种梦境，便分裂了，与其他心灵显得如此不同，各有所好，甚至能够牺牲别人来满足自己的需求。And in these dreams, the mind is separate, different from other minds, with different interests of its own and able to gratify its needs at the expense of others. 这一切差异性究竟源自何处？ Where do all these differences come from? 它们一定好似发生于外在世界。Certainty, they seem to be in the world outside. 然而是谁在判断肉眼之所见绝对是心灵？ Yet, it is surely the mind that judges what the eyes behold. 全是肉眼所获的讯息，且赋予意义的也是心灵无疑。It is the mind that interprets the eyes' messages,and gives them meaning. 因此这个意义绝对不存在于外在世界。And this meaning does not exist in the world outside at all. 肉眼所见的现实其实都是人心想要看到的景象。What is seen as reality is simply what the mind prefers.是他把自己的价值层次投射到外界，然后再派遣肉眼去把它召回来的。Its hierarchy of values is projected outward, and it sends the body's eyes to find it. 肉眼必须透过那些分别相才能看见东西。The body's eyes will never see except through differences. 然而，之间的形成不是靠肉眼带回的讯息。Yet, it is not the messages they bring on which perception rests. 它完全是建立在心灵对那些讯息的评估上。因此，只有心灵才能对自己的说见负责。Only the mind evaluates their messages, and so only the mind is responsible for seeing. 唯有它能决定说见之物究竟是真实的还是虚幻的，是自己想要的还是不想要的，要带给身体的是快感还是痛苦。It alone decides whether what is seen is real or illusory, desirable or undesirable, pleasurable or painful. 错误的之见就是透过那擅长拣择取舍的分别心而潜入的。It is in the sorting out and categorizing activities of the mind that errors in perception enter. 因此修正的功夫必须由此下手。And it is here correction must be made. 心灵靠它先入为主的价值观来识别鉴定肉眼带回的讯息，是它在决定感官所搜集来的每一个资讯如何排列组合。The mind classifies what the body's eyes bring to it according to its preconceived values, judging where each sense dealt them its best. 这种判断基础何其荒谬。 What basis could be faultier than this? 他毫不自觉，这些与存在于他内的鉴定系统不谋而合的东西都是人心自己求来的。 Unrecognized by itself, it has itself asked to be given what will fit into these categories. 唯有如此，它才能断言自己的鉴定系统必然真实可靠。 And having done so, it concludes that the categories must be true. 所有的分别判断都是依据这一原则，因为整个世界的判断都建立在这个基础上。 On this, the judgment of all differences rest, because it is on this that judgments of the world depend. 这种混淆人心且荒诞不经的推论逻辑怎么可能值得信任？ Can this confused and senseless reasoning by depended on for anything. 疗愈也没有难易之分，因为所有的疾病都是幻象。 There can be no order of difficulty in healing merely because all sickness is illusion. 当你治疗精神病患时，难道正是大一些的错觉幻象会比小规模的错觉更难驱除？ Is it harder to dispel the belief of the insane in a larger hallucination as opposed to a smaller one? 难道声音响亮一点的幻听会比轻声细语的幻听更容易使他信以为真？ Will he agree more quickly to the unreality of a louder voice he hears than to that of a softer one? 难道在他耳边轻声怂恿他去杀人的幻音会比大声的命令更容易让他听落网闻？Will he dismiss more easily a whispered demand to kill than a shout? 难道魔鬼手持的耙子有几根叉会改变他对魔鬼的相信程度？ And do the number of pitchforks the devils he sees carrying affect their credibility in his perception?他的心灵一旦把他们全都鉴定为真实之后，他们对他便全都变成真的了。 His mind has categorized them all as real, and so they are all real to him. 唯有等到他明白这一切全是幻想，他们才会消失踪影的。When he realizes they are all illusions, they will disappear. 疗愈的道理也是如此， and so it is with healing. 幻想之间的差异性影响不了大局的，因那些形形色色的分别相和幻想本身一样虚幻不实。 The properties of illusions which seem to make them different are really irrelevant, for their properties are as illusory as they are. 上主之师的眼睛仍会看到万物的差异性， The body's eyes will continue to see differences. 可是已经疗愈的心灵再也不会与它认同了。But the mind that has let itself be healed will no longer acknowledge them. 虽然有些人看起来好像病得比较严重，肉眼也会早就报道病情的发展。There will be those who seem to be sicker than others, and the body's eyes will report their changed appearances as before.但已疗愈的心灵会把他们全数归类于同一个虚幻不实的范畴里。But the healed mind will put them all in one category. They are unreal. 那位圣师给他的礼物就是帮他了解人心从外在的表象世界所接收的讯息只能归纳为两大类。This is the gift of its teacher, the understanding that only two categories are meaningful in sorting out the messages the mind receives from what appears to be the outside world. 而其中只有一类是真的， and of these two, but one is real. 既然实相是全然的真实与大小、形状时间及空间无关，因为差异性无法立足于实相之境。同理，幻想之间其实也没有什么分别。Just as reality is wholly real apart from size and shape and time and place, for differences cannot exist within it, so too are illusions without distinctions. 不论哪一种疾病，只有一个答复就是疗愈。 The one answer to sickness of any kind is healing. 不论哪一种幻象，也只有一个答复就是真相。 The one answer to all illusions is truth.
教师指南 Manual for Teachers 八，如何避免难易有别的观念。 8. How canPerception of order of difficulties be avoided. 祝大家有个闪闪发光、充满爱的一天。阿门。我爱你。